Hi everyone and welcome back to another card making video. Today I have a fall project and I will be working with products from the latest card kit by Simon Says Stamp. This is the October card kit, it's all about fall. And for a chance to win one of these card kits, make sure to visit my blog because I have a giveaway there. So first let's start with the paper pad. In a lovely fall color combo, you will get 12 double-sided pages. These are from a collection by Simple Stories, which is called Cozy Days, and the pages are 6x8. Lots of pattern papers in muted colors with flowers, oranges, lots of leaves. You will get two of those pages where you can cut them out and they can create the focal point for your card. And now let's take a look at the envelopes in two colors. One of them is shiny. You will also get these two packs of stickers. These are by American Crafts. One of them has tiny dog stickers, the other one has tiny cat stickers, perfect for all pet animals out there. This kit is a great value for money. You will get two stamp sets in there. The first one, the big one, is a 6x8 one and it's called Happy Fall. Lovely images, big focal points. You can color them with your favorite mediums. And it comes with many sentiments as well. I will actually be using this stamp set today for my card. And now let's take a look at the smaller one. This is 2x3. It gives you a couple of houses and sentiments and it's called Loving You From Afar. Always remember that if you like specific products that are included in the kit, you can get them individually and you will find the links down below. You also get three A2 white scored cards. These are by Simon Says Stamp. And here is a package of puffy alphabet stickers. These are by Pink Fresh Studio. There is a lowercase and uppercase and many duplicates of each one of the letters. So you can create your own sentiments for your project. And finally, these are the four colors of cardstock that you get. These are perfect for creating cards for fall, and this is exactly what I'm going to do today. So I'm going to start by stamping the pumpkin from the stamp set as well as a leaf, and I'm going to stamp that with black ink that is alcohol friendly, since I'm planning to use my alcohol markers to color everything. Now I switched to my acrylic block just because I find it quicker to stamp smaller images. So I did stamp the leaves a few more times and I'm also going to stamp a couple of mushrooms that are available in the stamp set. I'm going to create a little composition of the pumpkin and all those bits and pieces to create a focal point for my card. For coloring, I'm going to use my Triblend brass markers. These are three markers in one barrel and I'm going with the autumn hues. These three markers is what I got in a set of Triblends. The one that I'm using now for the pumpkin is the burnt orange blend. And I'm also going to bring in two more colors, which are the dull green blend and the gold brown blend. If you are one of my followers, you already know that I don't like to spend too much time coloring my images. I prefer to play around with the different elements and design my final composition. So I always like to do quick coloring and I find that these markers are perfect for that. I don't have to look through my stash of markers to find which are going to blend nicely. I have everything in one marker and I'm ready to go. So for the leaves, I'm going with browns and greens. And I'm even going to mix greens with browns in one leaf just to give that fall look. And I'm sure you can do a better job than me in coloring. I just like to do it super quickly, but I am happy with the results. For the mushrooms, I went with the same color palette, so these three markers were enough for coloring all the images. One way to go is to stamp them with masking, so you can create your composition from the beginning and then cut it out altogether or just stamp that directly on your card base. I like to pop things on my cards, I like to have dimension. That's why I usually stamp them, color them and then use my scissors to fuzzy cut them. As I cut around them, I'm making sure that I leave a white border. Very thin, but it's still there. This is going to help that image pop against a busy background and at the same time it makes cutting easier. To add some shine and glitter on my card, I decided to bring in this glitter cardstock. This is by Tonic Studios and it's the Welsh Gold. I'm going to stick a piece of paper on top of that, so this way I will have a shiny border all around. And the pattern paper that I used is the one with all those leaves, perfect for fall cards. I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and stick that on top of a 4.25 by 5.5 brown panel, and this is one of the cardstock that was included in the kit. Now, if you notice, those die cuts don't stand out against that busy background, so I cut out this circle out of that glitter cardstock that I used for the background, and instead of sticking that at the center to create my composition on top, I decided to move things around a little bit to make it more interesting. So I'm going to combine that circle with a banner where I have already embossed my sentiment, and I went with Hey Pumpkin that I white embossed that, and I'm going to stick those together. I am using foam tape at the back to raise that banner. I'm using Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back of my circle, and I'm going to tag that underneath that banner. And now I have an area where I can nest all those little die cuts that I have created. For that, I'm using foam squares at the back. I'm going to pop that pumpkin at the center of my circle, and then all around I'm going to create a little composition. This is a lovely design, perfect for fall. You can switch the sentiment, and it can be great for Thanksgiving as well. Any sentiment would go nicely on this one. It can even be a birthday card for fall if you like. I'm adding the final touches with those adorable mushrooms. And then just to add even more sparkle on this card, I'm going to use some copper gems. There are already little dots all around the background, so these are the dots that I'm going to follow to add my glue there and then stick the gems on top. And an embellishment wand for this job is super handy. You can see how easy it is for me to manipulate those gems. Now my panel is ready. All I need to do is to stick it on top of an A2 card. So I'm going to bring in one of those pre-scored ones included in the kit. I'm going to reinforce the scoring line with my bone folder. And finally, I'm going to use my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back and stick it on the front of the card. I like to use liquid glue instead of a tape runner or double-sided tape, just because before this glue dries, I do have some time to slide that on top of the card and make sure that I have the perfect placement. Here are some close-up photos on today's card. Don't forget, I have a giveaway on my blog. If you want to win this card kit, make sure to go over there and leave me a comment. Just like always, down below in the description area, you will find links to everything I used. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired, and until next time, stay safe.